Foreign Affairs at the Department of Foreign Affairs Head Office. She obtained her Bachelor of Arts in Organizational Communication from the University of the Philippines. So ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present to you our speaker today, Ms. Frances Louisa Cleofas, Vice Consul of the Philippine Consulate General, Australia. And for today's forum, your moderator will be Ms. Marilyn Andres Chan. So may I invite both the speaker, please?
Would you be speaking here or sitting?
Will you take there?
While waiting for the presentation here on screen, so I'll be proceeding to the presentation itself, because I only have I was given 1.5 hours. I think until 12:30 for the whole presentation and the open forum. And I know time is precious, so I also want to keep it, direct to the point and proceed with it, with the presentation, so that we can entertain more questions. I know after the presentation there might be more questions related to the presentation or maybe something that I've not discussed covered in the presentation. So, as mentioned by Attorney Kate, I will be covering two topics, two subject matters, and I will be discussing it one by one. So after discussing the dual citizenship, I'll be opening the floor for questions first before proceeding to protocol. But first of all, I'd like to thank Attorney Andres for inviting me to this event, to this occasion, and to be able to speak about one of the services of the Philippine Consulate General in Sydney. So may I ask, before proceeding to the actual presentation, may I ask who here are dual Filipino-Australians? Oh, marami-rami, yes. Thank you. Okay, you may put that in your hands. Maraming salamat po. So, with this, I know that some of what I will be covering, you already know. Some of you already know. But for the others, this may be new to you, or maybe something you've wondered about. Okay. Okay, so dual citizenship. We may frequently hear other Filipinos ask another kababayan here in Australia or somewhere around the world, nakapag-dual ka na ba? Have you applied for dual citizenship? But actually, the Philippine law is entitled Citizenship Retention and Reacquisition Act of 2003. In the law, it doesn't actually mention dual citizenship, and it does not limit the citizenship of Filipino citizens to just two. We usually call it dual citizenship because we speak of two citizenship, Filipino and a foreign citizenship. But actually, there's no limit. Okay. So, but before I discuss this 2003 law, I will go back to an earlier law just to provide more context on why we have this dual citizenship law. You may be asking, what happened? Why do I need to take oath-taking and apply for dual citizenship? It's because of an earlier Philippine law. So take note, it's a Philippine law implemented in 1936. And it is called the Commonwealth Act number 63. Okay. And this particular law provides further ways on how a Filipino citizen may lose his or her citizenship. And in section one of the ways here on how a Filipino may lose his or her citizenship is by means of naturalization in a foreign country. So because of that particular law, when a Filipino citizen becomes a naturalized citizen of another country, we automatically lose our Filipino citizenship. So that's the reason. That's the reason why they say, oh, I lost my Filipino citizenship. It's because of this earlier Philippine law. But in 2003, the Philippine Congress enacted this 2003 law to enable former Filipinos to regain their Filipino citizenship. Okay? So to retain or reacquire their Filipino citizenship. And the step for doing that is to, and the last